and I'm keep on going through. I actually got my electrical training trade school in prison, and I'm teaching people Microsoft Word, Office, Excel, PowerPoint. You know, and that's something positive in my life. When I get out, I'll be able to use that, start up a business. And if it isn't for God, I wouldn't be able to do any of this. And you know, I just want to thank God for it. And just look for what you're going to do in your life before you make the wrong choices. And so you don't end up here. You can learn from people like us, or people around you, older than you. We tend to, as children, we don't want to listen to them because we're stubborn-headed. And that's why we always end up in trouble, because we don't take advice from somebody that we need to. Thank you, and God bless.
Hi, my name is Leonard, presently incarcerated, Florida State Prison System. God's been in my life a long time. Actually, he built himself to me first in 1970 when I was in the hospital. And doctor told my mom I couldn't save my left leg or my right knee. And my mom and grandma prayed. I was in the VA hospital. And a chief surgeon came in and put me back together. But God actually built himself to me when I was in the hospital. And it's kind of a long story. But to make it short, I just want to tell you that as God has been in my life, and I got in trouble, I backslid, started hanging out with the wrong people, ended up in prison. This is my second go-around. I've been 5 years the first time. Now I'm doing 4.5 the second time. I had a 24-year gap. But when I was in prison the second time, I was in county jail. One of the guards, he was a Christian, he says, there's a purpose for you to be here. Well, I never could understand that. But he says, just read the Bible, you'll find it. Then when I was finally sent to prison, I was walking the yard with another inmate, and I was witness to him how God's answered a lot of my prayers, 4 of them to be exact. And he goes, well, that's your purpose. You have a strong testimony. I mean, he's actually healed me twice. And he's answered my prayer. When my mom died back in September 2010, a classification officer told me I would never go to work release or be minimum custody. And I couldn't understand why, because I'm sentenced for a non-violent drug charge. So I prayed about it for about 5 weeks. Next thing I know, I'm looking at the call out and I'm minimum custody. About 2 weeks after that, I was community. And my classification officer had nothing to do with it. She said I was selected from Tallahassee. Well, I told her I was chosen and blessed. And now I'm at Transition House in Kissimmee, which is a work release center and a transition phase. And we've been doing a lot of Bible studies here. I have my Bible studies from my own church. And Chaplain Perry's been a big inspiration in my life. And God has answered a lot of my prayers. And he showed me his love and his grace. And I know I will never fall again, because I know I got God in my life.
You're on.
Good evening. My name is Larry. I'm a resident in Florida, state of Florida. The story I'm about to tell is based on a true testimony. It's the truth. As a young man, I was raised in a Christian family, a Baptist church. Grateful mother and father. I was very proud of it. They raised me the right way, but I took the wrong ways on my own choice. I grew up in a small town in Georgia called Waycross. There, back when I was coming up, we were doing like integration. And my life just got off the track after the military, way before the military in high school. One of the type of kids that was what we call disobedient. Listen half of the time, half of the time I wouldn't listen. As I went along in life, then it come to that road where trouble follow you. And as our parents would tell us, as young men and women, things not to do, we decided to go ahead on out and do them anyway. after the football game, the basketball game, or whatever sports there is, what to do after high school, you know, after you get out of school in any time. Take different routes with different kids. Regardless of what class of kids you come from, as poor, halfway, or all the way, sometimes y'all end up together in the streets. One trouble thing to another. And that leads to what we call in society a jailhouse or some detention center. From marijuana to pills, even to the worst, cocaine and on down the line. If you're listening, you're old enough to understand, you know what I'm saying, when it comes to drugs. My first drug was marijuana for years. Got into that and wouldn't cope with school, education. The day I wish I would have. That led on to the hard stuff, up into the cocaine world. Got into that world, then it was all about the getting high and having that money. That was the worst part of it. Couldn't live without the money. Couldn't support your habit without it. And that goes on and on. And we follow that role, as I was saying, to take us into a world they call incarceration. And that's a role that sometimes take a long time to get away from. Many of those days that sitting in and out of jail became to be fun for a while. Your parents burning you out, sending you money, make you feel good, and you think you're in the big boy world then, or the big girl world. But I'd like to say today, that wasn't the world that you should choose today. Street life for like about 30 years for me, or better. After from 75 up until, I can say, this year, 2011, it was like in and out, up and down, sometime clean and sometime I wasn't. My best advice is to say, stay away from the trouble life in the streets, from drugs and alcohols and fast money. This year, after about 30 years, I said I would turn my life over to Christ and be sincere with it and be serious about it. Find hope. I've been finding blessing. And I found what faith was to have a relationship with my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And this faith led me to Him, to believe in Him. It truly has been changing my life. Not ashamed to say I'm in a program today here in Florida, in St. Clair, Florida. And I give my blessings and my grace to the God Almighty, His Son Jesus Christ, to be able to meet Reverend Perry. The last few months, I came a long way accepting Christ and wanting to do the right things. And the right thing is to walk with our Lord and our Savior Jesus Christ. Big advice, like I said, I can tell you, drugs and fast money is not the key to life these days. Your education, your loving parents and sisters and brothers. If you don't know Him, try to find someone that know Him and to teach you to know of Him until you accept on your own. It's not anyone else will, but your own. And the only way it happens is if you do it on your own and not by anyone asking you to do it or telling you to do it. It's something you have to want deeply from your heart and mind and soul. Today, I hope to continue and let not just be the first time that my voice may reach out to someone, touch someone's heart in my words, that you change your mind today and accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And I did that by my favorite description. I believe in Christ, and that would be 2 Corinthians 5:17. I'm not going to quote the description, just want you to open your Bible and read it for yourself and make your own choice. And with that, may God bless you and hope to speak out to you again. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Ed. And if you're listening to this testimony, it's because you're looking for something. And I was looking for something once myself. When I was young, a man told my dad, he said, "You're going to be very proud of that boy someday." My dad said, "I already am proud of him." But that always stuck in my head, and I wanted to make my dad very proud of me, as well as everyone. I wanted everyone to be proud of me. And I graduated high school, I went into the Air Force, and I started drinking, and I started drinking a lot, and I started getting in trouble. I wasn't going to work. Eventually, I got a DUI, I got an Article 15, I was discharged from the military. When I got out of the military, I got my life together, and I was walking with the Lord, and I was faithfully walking with the Lord, and He was really blessing my life. And I was seeking Him because I wanted the light that I heard about many of the pastors speak of, the light that the Bible speaks of, the light that God gives, that gives you enlightenment to the truth. And I found it. And I was enlightened, and my life was very blessed. But then I started turning back to my drinking. And all my blessings fell away, and my life started falling apart. And I had a wife I was married to, a wonderful wife, 13 years, and she left me. And so I cried out to God, said, "God, put me back together again." And He started putting me back together again as I started following Him. And I was an electrician, and I still had this great need to be looked highly upon. And so I really poured myself into my work, and I studied hard, and I gained lots of knowledge, and I rose up in my field of the construction field and the electrical field. And everybody noticed me for the knowledge that I had because I had studied so hard. But the knowledge wasn't enough. I wanted glory. I wanted people to give me praises. And so I put all my knowledge to work, and I became one of the best in the county at what I did. And everywhere I went, I received praises for the wonderful hard work that I did. But every time I rose to the top, I would always go back to my drinking. And every time I went back to my drinking, my life started falling apart and falling apart and falling apart. And eventually, I wound up in prison for burglary. And in prison, there, I sought after the Lord again, crying out to the Lord, "Lord, reestablish me. Set my feet back on solid rock. Make me the man that you want me to be. I can't do it myself. I keep trying and I keep failing every time I turn away from you, Lord. What is it with me why I can't do it?" And He revealed it to me that I can't do it. No man can do it. Only He can do it. And so I opened up my heart again and gave myself to the Lord again. And the Lord is a God of second chances. And in prison, it's a bad place to be. But God can bring good.